Wakanda forever!
Hello guys, this is your pal Nikki2001 here, and welcome back to my review leading up to Tom and Jerry movie. We got two movies to go. We got The Lego Movie 2, and tomorrow will be a Scoob rant, and the One Animation Group review will come to a close. And after Tom and Jerry review on February 27th, I'm going to do a movie review flash rant on a Suicide Squad movie. That's right, the DCEU review, I'm going to finish it leading up to Zack Snyder's Justice League. Well, that movie don't come out on March 18th. So anyway, now that I'm back on track. So today, I'm going to do a review, one of the biggest flop at the box office. It's none other than The Lego Movie 2, the second part. Came at the year, one of my favorite year of movies. The same year of a stupid Child's Play movie, which honestly no one give a crap about a Child's Play movie because I'm never a huge fan of a Child's Play movie. Brightburn, I don't want to get started talking about that awful movie. I respect Money Puff opinion, but for me, it's really disgusting movie, so. Good Boys, overrated. And my favorite movie of all time is Frozen 2. Alright guys, that's enough that. Let's get the plot, shall we? The basis part is the movie takes place after the first movie left off. It's about Emmett, Wildstyle, Batman, Metalbeal, Spaceship, the Spaceship Guy, and Unikitty. They have an apocalypse. I am so sorry about that, guys. Let's try this again. Basically, this movie takes place after the first movie left off, and this movie's about Emmett, Lifestyle, Metalbeal, Spaceship, Batman, and Unikitty all panic because of a baby Lego bricks. I really don't know what the name of a Lego brick. And you know what, guys? Just give me a favor. Put the combo below with that Taro Lego Brick's name, so I forgot. I'll call them a baby Lego Brick. So it's about baby Lego Bricks destroying all the Legos, and so Emmett and Wildstyle was holding hands, and Emmett say everything could be awesome. And the next day, Justin Lee character leave, and then the next day into a Mad Max. But this is way better than Mad Max we have in the Resident Evil, the final chapter. I don't want to talk about that movie. Alright, so Wildstyle and Emmett experiencing that Sweet Mayhem, which honestly, she's my favorite character of the movie. Her helmet, So it was about Avengers, about Emmett and Rick Dangerfield saving Y-style Batman and blah blah blah. And I basically put it, this story is really confusing as crap. It's even more confusing than the Spider-Man 3. I'm very sorry about that, guys. This story is really complicated to follow up, so it's really complicated. But I know you can put a comment below. Keep saying this story is not really confusing. What is my opinion? What is my opinion? You gotta respect it. All right, so let me tell you the backstory of this movie. All right, after I heard they're making a Lego movie 2, and after I saw the Lego Ninjago movie, and I would say to myself, I like the Lego movie first movie, but this movie could be bad, but I'm excited for it. Yeah, guys, I was not excited for this movie announcement. After I watched that disappointing Lego Ninjago movie, and make me watch hope for the Lego movie 2. But Chris Miller didn't direct this movie. I probably who directed this movie. Maybe sure it is. It's Mike Mitchell. You don't know what that director is who directed The Chore and the second worst movie from 2011 is none other than Alvin the Chipmunk Chick-Wrecked. And I was stepped down and I am not excited for this movie. So after I saw the trailer, and I was saying to myself, Mike Mitchell, you did a fantastic job. This is way better than Alvin the Chipmunk Chick-Wrecked. You know my opinion on Alvin the Chipmunk Chick-Wrecked? It's really cringe. It's really stupid. So, probably not December, I would do an extreme rant on that. But not now, so. So, Mike Mitchell, I'm very apologize because I'm about to destroy your driver's license, and your director's license. But you build this movie up, and so you did a fantastic job. Well, I like Chris Miller better than Mike Mitchell. So, Mike Mitchell is okay. Sometimes to make more great movie like the Lego Movie 2, and sometimes to make more monkey poop like Alvin the Chipmunk Chick-Wreck. And you know what? I don't want to talk about that movie because that movie is really annoying as heck. So, I was planning to see this movie in theaters, and so I did. I saw it on Valentine's Day. Yup, I saw this movie on Valentine's... Oh, wait a minute. What's this movie came out anyway? Yeah, what's this movie came out? Don't worry, I'll be quick, guys. Alright, this movie came out... God damn it. So, this movie came out on 8. So, I saw this movie on Valentine's Day. So, yup. What a perfect movie to watch it on Valentine's Day. But, I watched this movie. What did I think of it? Well, originally I say it was good, but I like the first movie better. But I watched it again on Cartoon Network because, yep, Cartoon Network airing the Lego Movie 2. And I hope they don't air that. I hope they don't air that movie again because if they air the movie again, Cartoon Network is going to make me hate the movie. So, this is the main reason why I hate Cartoon Network now. Alright, back by saying, so... I watched it again on DVD on Cartoon Network. So what did I think of it? I really love this movie. But it has some few negative about it. Well, the Lego Movie 1 don't have any negative, but the same thing the Lego Ninjago movie. It's some thing that's really mean spirit, so. So yeah, it's just my opinion. Yeah. I really enjoyed this movie. It's Frozen 2 Fantastic Four, second favorite movie from 2019. His number one is, oh, come on, it's Frozen 2. I keep saying everything for Frozen 2, but I'm doing this for Frozen 2 Fantastic Four. Hey, don't judge me, I can do what I want. So, but sadly, after this movie came out, people just did not like this movie. People think it's mediocre. People think it's good or bad and mediocre, one of the worst Lego movie ever. Well, this is really the Last Jedi of the Lego movie. Yup, that's right. This is really a Star Wars The Last Jedi out of the Lego movie because Reason why? Because of credit. A credit don't like this movie. And I really don't know what Grace Randolph really thought of this movie. I'm sure she will like it, same thing to Scoop. I respect her opinion on Scoop. But for me, it's really a disappointing movie in history. So I'll tell you the reason why tomorrow. So stay tuned. Well, I got that disappointment. So I got that movie on hold. Well, we're not going to be on hold. Well, I'm not going to put Scoop Rant on hold because on February 26th, I got a review of the Tom and Jerry movie, so yeah, hope you understand that. So as this movie came out, people's not a fan of this movie. In the box office, I was not happy at the box office. I was not happy at the box office because this movie, because the Wagon and Jog movies is the very first movie had been flopped at the box office. And I'm probably the Lego Bat movie have it, so didn't make the money back, I think. So kids. So if you're saying why the Wagon movie 2 bomb on me flop at the box office, well, this movie came out of that came out in February. It came out the exact same month as How to Train Your Dragon 3. A lot of people saw How to Train Your Dragon 3 more than the Wagon movie 2. So, How to Train Your Dragon 3 made more money than the Wagon movie 2. And after the box office, I probably won't get the Wagon movie 3. I'm probably my idea for Wagon movie 3 is called the Wagon movie 3, the Summer Vacation. And I'm probably all you're going to say is a rip off the Hotel Transylvania Summer Vacation. Which, honestly, I do not like Hotel Transylvania 3 Summer Vacation. I like the first movie, I like the second movie, but the third movie is really stupid. So, I'm just going to make it better. So, that's enough telling my backstories. Did I have any positive? Yeah, I have positive. Let's get the positive first, and let's get the negative later, because negatives start last. So, you know what? The story is really complicated, so let's put that in negative. So, let's get the animation. Once again, animation work absolutely gorgeous. Lego, when animation group Lego would not let us down for the animation. So, I really like this Lego stop motion. This is way better stop motion than, Hell and Back. Oh my god, the movie's gone awful. I'm probably my after DCEU review. I'm just going to do an extreme mega game rant on Hell and Back because I watched this movie and it went absolutely terrible. Don't want to talk about that movie. That movie's gone awful. It's even worse than Sasha Party. You know I don't want to talk about the movie. So, once again, animation look absolutely amazing. So, the character, let's get the character, shall we? Emmett, he's fantastic. Lucy has some more screen time than in the first movie. Because the first movie focused with Emmett. And in the second movie, the follow the character with Lucy. And River Vervain, she did a fantastic job. Well, my daughter, River Vervain, she's an okay actress. She was in bad movies like Charlie Angel Reboot, or Remake, or Reboot, whatever you call it. And a stupid Happy Time Murder, which honestly is not at all the worst movie from 2018. I don't know what the worst movie I've seen in my life. I hate the freaking movies. So, Lucy, she did fantastic. This is way better than Charlie Angel. Because, reason why? Because that movie came out the exact same year. Well, I don't hate the movie because of female. Because I hate that movie because, it's really stupid. So, yeah, let's get to kill the Batman. The Batman, he's right here. Yeah, the Batman, he has some lot more screen time than the first movie. Well, you have his spinoff movie, and I really like his spinoff movie. And also, I did a review on his movie. Well, I'm probably all of your country didn't see my review because of all that stupid YouTube copyright claim. So I just wrote that video up for a memory. So sorry, you can't watch it. Sorry, I'm not gonna do it. It took me 2 hours. I'm not gonna do that 2 hours. And I am not putting Yellow and Black. I hate that song. So I refuse putting that song. So, let's get to Unikitty. Unikitty, she's cute. And the spaceship guy and the metal beer, they're not barely in this movie. Well, they're kinda in the scene, but, I don't know. But my favorite character of this movie is other than Sweet Mayhem. Sweet Mayhem is out of my favorite character of this movie. It's not because of Helmet, it's not because of Deep Voice like Batman, but I really like her helmet. And I really like her face. Her face is really cute to look at. And I'm sorry just for spoiling it. Well, it doesn't matter. Well, people, it doesn't matter because McDonald's just helped me spoil the movie because let me tell you the backstory of it. And I was at McDonald's of 2019. Give me a chicken nugget, french fries, all that yummy stuff. So I was looking at the McDonald's toy and I was like a Sweet Mayhem face. And I was saying myself, wait, did McDonald's spoil that scene? McDonald, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? That is not... McDonald, what is wrong with you? What in the heck is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? This is not okay. You could spoil the movies. Even worse than Toy Genie say Magic Hand, and that was really stupid. Magic Hand is not really... don't exist. Oh my god. One more crap of Toy Genie. I'm gonna put Toy Genie on the top... my top 5 worst YouTuber ever. So... yeah. To make Free Man feel better. Yeah, Sweet Mayhem, she's a cute character. And I do not like her helmet because her helmet... because her helmet act like a deep voice like this. Okay, that's enough. that was really cringe. And let's not forget Tiffany Haddish's. Yep, in 2019, it was Tiffany Haddish's day. She was in Secret Weapon Pet 2, and it was okay. It was okay, so I've been in the first movie. And she was in the Angry Bird movie too, which honestly, I do not like that movie. It's one of the most overrated movies from 2019. And I haven't seen Dora the Lost City of Gore, which honestly, I'm not a huge fan of Dora, and I am not wasting my time watching that god-awful movie. Because the trailer absolutely sucks. But I really like this character. The character, she's so cute, and they show, and yeah, she's so cute. I don't want to say sexy because Lego's not that sexy to look at. So yeah, the action scene. I really like the action scene. Lego movie has some great action scene. The Lego movie, the first movie, has some amazing, fantastic action scene. The Lego Batman movie has some awesome action scene. And the Wagon the Jog movie has some good action scene, but sometimes I have a punch, kick, punch, kick, punch, kick, punch, kick, like Kung Fu Panda 3. Well, don't get me wrong, people, I like Kung Fu Panda 3. I just don't like a karate fight. It's lame. So, what else has to say about this movie? And I think the ending, I really like the ending, it's great. But I just have some few negative. It's not a lot of negative, I just have a few. Alright, let's get started. The first off, the story is really complicated as crap because every time I do a review on the videos and it keeps saying the story and I keep confusing. So it's really confusing. So I'm a special needs to put a comment below and tell me to fix my brain. So God made me that way. So there's nothing you can do about it. So I'm a special needs, because as a YouTuber, it's special needs, so I don't want to talk about that god-awful music movie. Hate that movie. Oh yeah, I forgot one thing. It's the one character I really do not like is none other than Reg Dangervet. Yeah, I do not like that character. That character is one of the worst character of the second worst one animation group villain I have ever seen in my life. And the number one is Dick Dastardly from Scoob. You know what? I just want to talk about the movie tomorrow. So stay tuned. Well, one person don't come. So, honestly, I respect your opinion on Reg Dangervet. But sometimes Reg Dangervet is really unlikable to Emmett because I do not like Reg Dangervet. Reg Dangervet is really a Hans out of the Wagon movie. It's really a Hans version out of the Wagon movie. That's right. Reg Dangervet. Yup, his twist villain is absolutely stupid. It's absolutely stupid. It's even more stupid when the Hans twist villain from Frozen 1. And I'm not talking about Frozen 2 because he's not in Frozen 2. Well, don't get me wrong, he was in Frozen 2. And thank God Elsa, I'll just knock him down. So he deserves it. Yeah, so yeah, I do not like like Danger Van. I'm probably here pretty soon. I'm just going to make a grand series out of him. Deserve it. Well, I don't want to copy the YouTuber because GoAnimate did that. Ugh, I hate the GoAnimate. So, I'm going to get to the human scene. The human scene was completely unnecessary. It's completely unnecessary. Like, Main Randolph. Where'd you get that name? Grace Randolph? Well, you know I'm going to get to that. So, I think the mom character was unlikable to the kids. Like, putting your Lego away. What the heck is that? You want to get a job? You want to act like grown up? You know, I don't want to talk about that. So the human scene, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to spoil it. The human scene is really completely unnecessary. The Lego movie, the first movie, the Lego Ninjago movie, the human scene is way better than the second movie. So, three negative and a lot of positive. So, holy crap, this review was longer. Alright. Alright, that means it's gonna take forever to vote. Alright, so overall, guys, The Lego Movie 2 is an enjoyable movie, and this movie will replace of the Addams Family in my best movie from 2019. And I don't understand why I put the Addams Family in the best movie from 2019. I watched that movie again, and I was saying to myself, I was really stupid back then. So now, The Lego Movie 2 is now replaced, to the god-awful Addams Family. No, I'm not talking about the original. I'm talking about the new one. Alright, so overall, guys, I'm gonna give The Lego Movie 2 a 9 out of 10. It is an amazing film. So, kids, if you haven't seen The Lego Movie 2, I highly recommend you see this movie. But if you hate this movie, I respect opinions. But for me, I really enjoyed it. But it's not as good out of the first movie. The first movie is way better than this. Well, don't get me wrong, kid. I really like this movie. I really love it. But it just has a few negatives. The story, and the human scene is really all this is underwhelming. Alright, I highly recommend you see this movie, and if you want to buy this movie on DVD, just go ahead, because this movie's no longer on HBO Max. I don't know why you removed that. It's on Cartoon Network. So if you want to see The Lego Movie 2, hey, probably next time Cartoon Network will be happy to air that. And I'm very so sorry about that, guy. People keep uploading Tom and Jerry TV spots. So good thing it's not a spoiler scene. Alright, guys. That was my movie review out of the... I am very so sorry about that, guys. I'm saturating. Back with saying. So yeah, that was my movie review. On The Lego Movie 2, the second part. You know what, I'm going to call it The Lego Movie 2, because calling the second part is absolutely stupid. Because the first movie didn't call it the first part, and then the sequel called it the second part, so I'm going to call it The Lego Movie 2. Alright, let's try it again. Alright, guys, that was my movie review on The Lego Movie 2. Tell me what you thought on The Lego Movie 2. You think it's one of the mediocre movie? Or just like me, it's a great movie. It's not as good as the first movie. Alright, comment below and let me know. And stay tuned, oh boy. This is the big one. Your wait is over. Tomorrow, stay tuned for my movie review fresh rant on the movie I originally love, but now I hate. You know what? I'm just going to show it. Yup, Scoob. Yep, stay tuned for that movie review by Shrant. Probably after I upload that video tomorrow, my subscriber will get a hateful comment about my movie and my opinion. I'm very sorry about that, guys. And I'm probably going to say, what? You hate Scoob and you love Frozen 2? You suck. I hate you. Guys, it's just my opinion. It's just my opinion. Well, same thing to play Amigami sneak peek. I'm just going to do a sneak peek of my Scoob movie review. Movie review if I should. Well, I don't fancy doing a sneak peek because it's completely unnecessary. So yeah, stay tuned for my movie review on the worst one animation group because this movie ruined Scooby-Doo. Alright, so guys, if you like my content, hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and I'll probably today I'm doing some more Frozen 2 trailer style. Well, you know what, I'm just going to take a break making video. I'm just going to upload some random videos, some random Frozen 2 videos, so stay tuned for that. And so yeah, after I upload it, I will be done today, and I will be done. Alright, Nick gotta go, and this is Nick signing off. Alright, see you next time. So long. Peace, YouTube!
What would I do without you? You'll always have me.